The Haunting of Bly Manor, a new horror drama series from Mike Flanagan, follows an American au pair who takes a position caring for and educating two orphan children at a large country estate after their previous nanny's unexpected death. Needless to say, this manor is very, very haunted. But is it also real? Is The Haunting of Bly Manor a true story? The Haunting of Bly Manor is directly inspired by many short stories by writer Henry James, as well as his 1898 horror novella, The Turn of the Screw, which is loosely based on real supernatural accounts from Hinton Ampner House in Britain. Writer Henry James first learned about the ongoing incidents that began in April of 1771 at Hinton Ampner House from the Archbishop of Canterbury. The entire case was documented in Gentleman's Magazine in 1872 and provided direct inspiration for The Turn of the Screw. In the mid-18th century, several mysterious deaths and disappearances occurred in the home. The magazine published a series of letters from every resident since, detailing the hauntings. These include mentions of music, whispers, footsteps, fabric rustling, doors opening and closing of their own accord, and other inexplicable sounds. The letters also detail sightings of two haunted figures and the disturbances of a poltergeist. A man in a drab-colored coat and a tall, dark woman materialized repeatedly at Hinton Ampner House. Henry James included many of these supernatural details in the creation of his novella, and they can clearly be seen in The Haunting of Bly Manor as well. Furthermore, major plot points of The Haunting of Bly Manor seem to align with the real-life details of the deaths and misdeeds of the residents of Hinton Ampner. Without spoiling the series, a buried box of treasure, romantically jealous siblings, a wife's death, and children conceived out of wedlock were all thought to have contributed to the hauntings at Hinton Ampner House, just as they do at Bly Manor. Beyond the source material, the recurring thrill elements in The Haunting of Bly Manor are also based on real-life incidents. Sentient evil dolls have been a terrifying element in media from The Twilight Zone to Toy Story 4, but their real-world history dates back much farther. The earliest haunted dolls were spiritual vessels used in ancient religious and sacred ceremonies across many cultures and continents. Some dolls were associated with protection and healing, while others had more sinister purposes, like cursing the living. The crude homemade talisman dolls that Flora places around Bly Manor most closely resemble poppets. In folk magic and some witchcraft, these simple figures represent a specific individual and are meant to help that person in some way with magic. Flora seems to have similar intentions for her talismans. Of course, these aren't the only dolls in Bly Manor. We also see some more traditional human figures whose actions are inspired by modern accounts of real haunted dolls. In the early 1900s, a life-size doll called Robert Jr. terrorized a family. He whispered threats, moved around on his own, and even changed his facial expression. In the 1970s, a Raggedy Ann doll reportedly relocated herself, left threatening notes, and attacked people. A psychic determined the toy had been possessed by the spirit of a child named Annabelle. Mandy, a porcelain doll from 1910 who cries at night. La Pasqualita, a lifelike mannequin from 1930 who changes positions. And Okiku, a Japanese doll who grows her own hair, are just a few more sinister examples. In The Haunting of Bly Manor, Danny has a habit of covering mirrors in cloth. Historically, this was a centuries-old practice employed in a house where someone died or was dying. Different cultures had different specific reasons for covering the mirrors, including protecting a deceased soul, preventing death from looking in, and keeping the living safe from seeing death themselves. Ancient Romans believed that souls could become trapped in mirrors, and in the Victorian era, mirrors were thought to be portals to the afterlife, and were often used in attempts to contact the dead. Just as with the haunted dolls, there are some specific mirrors with a long history of supernatural occurrences. The 200-year-old mirror at the ghost-filled Myrtles Plantation in Louisiana is perhaps the most famous. Visitors report seeing handprints, spreading stains, and even figures in 19th-century clothing in the glass. Aside from their haunted history, mirrors have long been imbued with deep symbolism. Since mirrors provide a literal reflection of the self, leading psychologists hypothesize that people can find them disturbing when they are unable to confront their own psyche. In Bly Manor, any reflective surface, including water and windows, can have the same impact as a mirror. And generally, the characters looking into those mirrors are in a tricky state. Whether or not you believe in ghosts, the knowledge that actual accounts may have inspired the producers of The Haunting of Bly Manor just makes the series that much more unsettling. While this show may not exactly be a true story in the traditional sense, it draws on enough real-world references, inspirations, and details to make it frighteningly realistic. What's your opinion on all these accounts of real-life hauntings? Tell us in the comments below. And watch The Haunting of Bly Manor on Netflix now.